hour at 3 o'clock in the morning. Mm-hmm. I still ain't sitting in a karma. Like, because one thing about them, bro, we arrogant as shit sometimes, mm-hmm, towards each other. Mm-hmm. So if she gonna send it to me, I ain't gonna send it to her. You feel what I'm saying? And at the time, I still felt like I was like, bro, only thing I did was ask the girl to do a video. You feel what I'm saying? Like, bro, you got like, I tried to talk to the girl first. Girl, I ain't do none of that shit. You feel me? And then, on top of that, you know what I'm saying? I'm already dealing with a whole bunch of other shit. You feel me? I'm trying to get my tour ready. I'm trying to make sure dude had told my trail up. So I'm trying to make sure my shit ready before I go home. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I had so much shit on my back. You feel what I'm saying? So it was like, all right, boom, we going at it. Woo-doo. It was Sunday morning. I made a tweet on Twitter, whatever. I don't remember what the fuck it was.
You said I'm gonna distance myself or something.
No, I said I'm isolating myself because she posted on Twitter. She was like mood, and I put on I like isolated myself or whatever. And then that thing, you know, I got them. I said something on Facebook. I feel like driving to Alabama myself.
No, you put it on Twitter.
Oh, at Twitter. Yeah. And I want to drive to Alabama myself. Yeah, and the reason
you think people don't know what y'all talking about each
other? Huh?
I'm not even on there, and I could figure that shit out. You think people gonna know that? That follow y'all?
But yeah, but see, the thing is, it's like,
ain't no but though. It's common sense, bro.
I feel like that's like, and I told him that when we talked, that when he posted that and he was like, he feel like going to Alabama by himself. I commented on it and I was like, you can't go because people's already swimming like
now
by yourself.
So she coming there and I come in something else. I had been.
Why don't y'all talk to each other,
bro?
Don't do that shit on the internet.
That's what we first why that we fucked up at. We
don't do that.
But I felt like the only reason I didn't talk to Corey after that was because I said what I had to say through message. So I was
like, bro,
to come home and talk.
My wife does better like that. She does better texting and stuff.
We both do that. We both do that, though.
Well, you respond to her freaking messages.
But this,
y'all could have done that through text. Don't do that shit. You give all these people stuff to talk about, man.
Yeah.
Don't give them that. Don't feed into the bullshit that these people want. People don't remember we had that we did that damn podcast and I told you, I said black people don't like to see black people succeed.
Right.
They don't want to see a successful black family that is young make it.
Right.
This is what people want. Controversy. Bullshit sells. Media. All this stuff, controversy sells. That runs ratings up. You're giving people what they want. When it's nice and it's that perfect situation, people don't want to watch that, man. People want the dramas and all that. Yeah. So by y'all giving them that, it's just people are just like, oh shit, Carmen and Corey into it all. Don't feed into that. Y'all, if you had heated messages for him, Carmen and Corey, you had heated messages, fucking text each other. Text each other. Y'all can talk shit through text. It's fine. It's the same tone. It's all that. But it's just y'all.
Right.
It's not these millions of people that are going to judge you 1,000 times worse than they already do.
Yeah, so I feel like, you know what I'm saying? Like, cause I was being ignorant at the time. Bro, I was literally sitting right upstairs. She was right in the room. And bro, we going in and on Twitter, bro. We like, we in the same fucking house.
In the same house.
And I even commented. I even put that on Twitter. I said something like,
So you really want to let people know who you're talking about now?
No, it was already understood that we were going in now at this point. It was.
You didn't have to say it. We were in the same.
And I was like, no, and I said, bro, you right downstairs. You really wanted to say that, you could have just said it to me or whatever. That's what I was. And so they were like, what's going on? So I had put on it all like,
no.
I
said, hey, don't tell me you gave me an answer.
No, hold on. We're going to wait. I said nothing, but I text the girl after a video. That's it. And Carmen, but guess what though? Get what Carmen do. They go on there and put the whole fucking screenshot of that.
No, because after you said that, I already got all the females looking at me like I'm insecure. So after you said that, people already thinking us, because we YouTubers, of course, you're supposed to ask people to do a video.
Yeah.
So they're looking at me like, oh, then Cardi so insecure. All you did was ask a female for a video. So I posted and I was like, okay, this is what Cory did. Mind you, we have been doing YouTube for 3 years. If we do find somebody, it got to go through our management. Like, mm-hmm. we don't just pick anybody from the street and do a video with them. Right. So I was like, this is exactly what Cory said. And I explained it, like, why I felt the type of the way that I felt. So after that, that's when Cory got more mad that I posted a screenshot. But it was more like, I'm not lying. Like, Cory did try to meet with a girl behind my back without communicating.
Who did a screenshot?
Me, I posted a screenshot of the
message. Come on, Cardi, no!
No! That's what made me madder. I was like, you didn't have to go that far, you feel what I'm saying? Like, because I wasn't trying to make her look bad, bro. It was like...
Because, Cory, like, one thing about Cory, he knows I'm not going to get on social media and really expose her being. I'm not going to do that. But then, I'm not going to let him give people more reason to come and keep attacking me without them knowing my side of the story.
Right, Cory, right, so, right.
You got to
right.
protect your wife, bro.
I know, bro. That's why I say, bro, it's like, I say, like, that's where I kind of, like, you know what I'm saying, open my eyes up. Well, I mean, I did, but I'm saying I had to sit down and really think, like, because I was, like, I've been gone for, like, the last past 3 days, bro. Like, I just been out around listening to music, easing my mind, trying to think, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay, what the fuck?
How many times I told you to call me?
Bro, you know how many people try to tell me to call? It just, bro, I'm going to tell you, I know that, but...
A lot of people going to shoot
because... Yeah, vast. But I don't know, bro. It's like, sometimes, bro, you know... I be trying my best to like teach myself and you know, I don't know. I don't like calling people when I got problems because.
I'm gonna tell you something I learned from a coach. In life, I learned it through football, but it's in life too. It's called, and it's for both of y'all. Either you can own it or you can borrow it. When you own something, you personally go through it. Whether it's you personally running into a wall, tripping over something, whatever it may be. If you borrow it, you learn from someone else's experience. If I'm walking and I trip over a hole and I say, hey, Cory, watch out, there's a hole right there. And you see the hole and you don't trip over it, you borrowed that because I owned it and you learned from it through my experience. So you don't necessarily have to try to do things on your own. You can learn through borrowed information. Or in situations like this, moving forward in your life, you can learn it through your own situation. So it's okay how you get it. It's best to borrow it, honestly. Yeah, it's best to borrow it. But in situations where sometimes you own it, it's okay to own stuff too. But it's best to borrow it. So, I mean, you got people around you. I know you have good people around you. And you have to utilize your resources at times. But I can tell both of y'all, the best thing that I've learned through therapy, and when my wife and I got together, we've been married going on 7 years, on July 25th, it'll be 7 years. We've been together, 12 years, I think, now.
Damn.
And, man, we got together in college, I think we were both 20. We were a couple months apart. I'm older than her by a couple months. We got together when we were 20, and the thing is, so much shit. She met me when I was young, dumb, and just trying to live.
I know. Yeah.
Superstar athlete. I just wanted to live. And but I knew what my dream one was going to be like, and it's like she walked in front of me. So long story short, I wanted the best of both worlds. I wanted to be a superstar athlete and live that life, but I also wanted to have my family at the same time.
Thanks.
And it clashed so much.
How you did it?
The best thing that I learned, bro, was I learned through a lot of stuff that I own. I literally had to own shit and learn through it. And luckily, I have a woman that came up and her parents have been together 30-something, almost 40 years now, to where she forgives. She forgives and she'll allow you to grow. It ain't easy.
Right, of course.
It's not easy. And we still go through our things here and there and... Where I was going is when we first got together and we were young, and our first time we went through something, she had told me about therapy. And I was the person that was like, man, that shit's stupid. All this, man, I ain't wasting my money on that. And I could get it free through the NFL. And I said, I ain't going to that. I said, there's nobody out there that can sit over there and tell me about myself. I've been in this body my whole life. You're not going to tell me about myself. You're not going to tell me what I need to do in my life. You ain't going to tell me none of that stuff. So, it literally took me screwing up like another 3 times to where as of like 3 years ago, 3 years ago, I messed around with my wife in New York and she found out about it bro, she was out. And it felt like my world was crumbling. And I was like, fuck, man, what am I gonna do? I didn't know what to do, so I started panicking. Like we all do when our wife about to leave us. You start panicking, and like reality sets in. All the stuff that you thought you wanted, it don't mean nothing to you now because you know what you really want.
Bro, that's
when they got one foot out the door and you see that shit's almost gone, and then especially when you got kids at home, and you know you're not gonna come home to CJ, I know I'm not gonna go home with my daughter and my son gonna run to me.
Man.
That all that fun and stuff, man, what? It really starts to make reality real. So where I'm going with this is it took me to be like, you know what? Hey, I'll do therapy. I'll do it. I'll do marriage. I'll do whatever we gotta do.
Right.
And the craziest thing is being with our and we picked a female counselor. I actually chose her. I was like, I ain't picking a woman, it's gonna be biased and it's gonna be all this and that.
Yeah.
She, man, her name is Courtney. And if y'all ever want to talk to Courtney, Courtney's amazing, man. Courtney is so great that she taught me to be able to step outside of myself and see it from a different point of view. You get so caught up looking at it from first person point of view all the time that you never say, you know what? How does Carmen see this? And then when you think about it, damn, that was stupid that I did that.
Yeah,
because when you flip it, how would you feel?
That's what I did. Actually, it was the day I was, because I had left the day, you know what I'm saying? I was listening to music, I was just driving, and I was trying to think, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, it was at a point, like, well, I didn't know, I had asked Carl, like, so what we going to do, you know what I'm saying? Like, we had made our mind, okay, we going to work out. But it was, like, I had sat back, bro, and I really kind of, like, just put myself outside, and I really saw, because what happened was, so I ain't getting to tell you, okay, so that was great. You know, we did it before, you know what I'm saying? That's like, well, what happened was it got so bad where I had went live Sunday night. But listen though, this is the crazy part about it. I didn't too much say nothing. I was just basically repeating what was said on Twitter. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I was just saying like what was said on Twitter and like what happened. But you know,
you went on, what went through your head to say, I need to go on live and talk about this? What made you know that this is okay?
The thing is, I didn't go on live to talk about it. I was just on live to talk about it.
Mind you, he broke up with me through Twitter twice. He made a post twice. He said, no more Carmen and Corey.
I had broke up with him because I felt like I was like, shit. So then how I looked at it.
First of all,
I'm going to tell you how.
You don't break up with your wife.
I know.
You're not boyfriend
girl. I felt like, bro, I was like, okay. First of all, the way she may have seen on Twitter, or not even Twitter, but the way everybody made it seem, everybody made it sound like I was just this low-down nigga, I just dog her, I don't love her, you feel what I'm saying? Everybody kept saying I cheated, and I'm like, nigga, I didn't even cheat. What the fuck is y'all talking about? Like,
you have to address everybody else?
No, I don't do that. No, put it like this. Okay, I'm going to tell you what type of nigga I am. I don't care what people say, but bro, no, I don't. It's a different.
You already had this conversation,
but
bro.
I'm telling you, though, listen.
You do.
No, I do not.
You do.
I care about my image, bro.
No, you care about other people's. You care about how other people look at you.
That's my image, though.
But you care!
Because I don't know if anybody think I'm something that I'm not.
So don't say you don't care, because you do!
It's a difference, though.
You, for it.
I can't argue with this nigga.
This is why I'm here.
Okay.
It's a yes or no question.
All right.
Do you care about what other people think?
Yeah.
Then you fucking care. Stop saying you don't.
Because, bro, I just turned my image.
Still care about what people.
Okay, so is that bad because I care about my image?
It's not, I'm not saying it's bad. I never said it was bad, but you care. You stop telling yourself you don't care when you do. Because if you really didn't care, you really wouldn't give a shit. I'm serious. You know how I be. You know how I be saying I really don't give a shit. I really don't. I can ignore the shit I do.
Yeah, he
does. Like, they can stand beside me and I can ignore the hell out of it. I do it to my wife.
I mean, I can do that too, though. That's a different thing.
No, you can't.
Oh, my mama, nigga.
You allow the most simple. I've been telling you for the longest. Stop entertaining bullshit.
Wait, bullshit sales. That's what people don't understand.
So you care. Stop saying you don't then. Because you do. It's nothing wrong with it. But you care, bro. You do. You got.
Right, so listen.
Before you tell that. My coach told me this. We were talking one day and he was asking me about something. It's about a play. Long story. And his point was trying to get me to admit that I was wrong. I was you. I was saying everything. No, man, I wanna. He said the first step to rehabilitation is admitting that you have a problem. So when people go to rehab, the first step to rehabilitation, excuse me, is admitting that you have a problem. You have to admit it first, Corey, before you can address it. You're still denying it, bro. Just admit it. Fuck, I do. You know what? I care about what people think about me. You do. You do. There's nothing wrong with it, though. But you do. Stop saying you don't when you really do. You do. Now, keep on.
Anyways. So, all right. So, I went so long without addressing it. You know what I'm saying? I was ignoring it. But they just kept coming. So I said, okay, damn, fuck it. Y'all want to know what happened. This is what happened. But so me not thinking social media, people on social media are so miserable, bro. They try their best to start shit the best way they can.
Don't give them. No, it's not me, bro.
They went to Carmen DM, and I guess they were telling her, because even Robert had texted me. Robert said, man, get off live, because they be twisting your words. They went to her and was telling her I was saying some shit that I didn't say. So she went live.
Did you stay on live?
No, yeah, I got off after she was on live.
Did you listen to Robert?
Yeah, I got off. She went live.
No, but the reason that really made me go live, I wasn't more of the DMs that I got. He was saying when I did got on his live, he was saying, he was like, man, I don't care about it no more. It seems like it's deeper than that, but I can show you that I can be somebody else who's going to appreciate you or something like that.
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did. Yes,
I didn't say I could get somebody to appreciate you.
So I was
basically just saying that. I was like, okay, well, if it's that serious, I'll just get some. Oh, right behind you. Where you look like someone?
Which one?
Right in front of you.
This one?
Up. Next one.
Right there. So I was just basically like, you know, and Carmen knows this, but sometimes, bro, when I get mad, bro, I just say some shit off the wall. I even told her, I was like, you know what? I promise that this is going to be something that I work on myself, you feel what I'm saying? Because, like, I got a bad attitude problem, bro. Like, a lot of people already know that about me. Like, bro, when I get mad, bro, like, I spaz out, you feel me? I don't give a fuck what come on my tongue. It's like I got a gun in my mouth. Like, I'm going to shoot you with every motherfucking thing I can.
You better get control of that.
Yeah, I am. Fierce. Trust me.
Only person.
So, yeah, I know that was bad about it. Because I had that mindset, bro. I was like, you know what? I don't give a fuck about none of this famous shit. Like, I'm human. Because it's like, people look at famous people like we fucking superheroes. Like, nigga, we don't have no feelings or nothing. Like, we have to take everything that comes to us.
That's why I got off social media.
Bro, that nigga ain't been on social media in 7 years.
It's pointless.
He don't got no Instagram. He don't got none of that shit.
That amount of time that I would spend scrolling doing nothing,
you could do it.
I take that time and I put it with my family. Yeah. I take that time to be productive. But think about how much useless time you do not posting, and you just.
Bro, that shit bad, bro. I addressed it a lot.
The money wasn't worth it. I understand y'all situation is different, but for me, the money wasn't worth it. It wasn't worth the stress in my life.
That's why I told Carmen, bro, right now, after the truck and shit, we invest. I'm trying to invest in some other stuff. We can invest, and I told her, bro, I said, like, next year or some shit, bro, the YouTube shit, the Instagram shit, bro, I'm done with it, bro. I want to get off social media. Like, I want to go back to. I mean that. Like, nigga, I swear to God, and my son, if I had one wish, my one wish would be that I would not famous. That's facts. I don't give a fuck about it. I want the money, but I don't want that fame. Because you got to think about it, bro. Before I got famous, I know how my life was before I was famous. I was able to...
But you control the narrative.
No, it's still different, though, bro. You can't... Nigga, you can go somewhere right now and I don't know you like that. Nigga,
but check this out. So it ain't about who knows you. It's not about who knows you. You said it yourself before in videos. You control what people see. True or false?
Facts.
You edit it, right?
Facts.
So you control the narrative. You fully control that. You control it.